Hi, I'm Vanquished Angel and welcome back to my channel. Today we're looking at Debian Live 9.4. This is a 64-bit operating system. I've adjusted the video memory to 128 megabytes on this one, and that's how much memory I set for it. As you can see, it's a Debian-based 64-bit. And so now we're going to go over the install. Here, Debian Live, start. And we're going to view full screen switch. And then we're going to go graphical Debian installer. I have used Debian before. This is a disclaimer, but it's been a long time. The issues I had before was getting certain drivers and things to work in it. I love Debian. I use Debian-based operating systems the overwhelming vast majority of my Linux computing. So I'm a big fan of Debian, but we'll see how this works as we go through the install process here. It's interesting that a lot of them are automatically doing IPv6. I noticed the host name Debian is fine. I don't care. Root password. Continue. Continue. Username will work. So many passwords. So some of them are actually that I've been testing out have actually been prompting you for different password for root. Now for the example, I've been using the same passwords for both, but you can set them differently, which is probably quite helpful because you can have friends or whatever logged into your account. So we're going to use the entire disk, why not? Yeah, sure. We're going to have to switch to manual for this because I have a feeling it's having a problem with not sure what's going on. So I guess we had to configure the updater. Hopefully this does not take too long. So Debian takes a little while to install. At least it jumped ahead there. Hopefully it's done. Perfect. Okay. Well, yeah. All right. This takes a little bit longer than the other ones. We're going to continue. And apparently, oh, it's removing. Now it's got to clean up. Are we there yet? Yes. Maybe. F12. I have to hit F12. Boot from the hard drive. Debian Linux. There goes. I don't remember. Did I get it right? I think so, because it would have been like, hey, you stupid idiot. You didn't do it right. It's just taking a while. Might be because it has no swap space, actually. But it should have more than enough RAM. Well, this certainly has taken a while. Well, that's certainly taken a while. There we go. Let's see what we got here in the menu. This really screams Linux Mint right here. Let's see what we got. I wonder if I click if it'll stay. No. All right, so comes with cheese, Brazero, that's your CD burning stuff, your calculator. Cheese is for your webcam. You can change backgrounds, yay. Looks like there's a dictionary editor. Oh, games, chess. So this is probably like, it's all applications, not accessories. How did I move? I probably moved right in the beginning. All right, so not sure what that is. A reference guide. Gnote, that's, I believe it's like a little sticky note. Yeah, it's kind of what it's supposed to be. All right, games. A lot of these are pretty cool games. You know, they're all right. Quadrupesals like Tex is like Tetris. Robot Sudoku, Fell Swoop, Tally, Trivex, Mahjong. Graphics, you have GIMP, Inkscape, Image Magic. There's Shotwell for pictures in the scanner. Internet comes with Firefox, ESR. I don't know what that means. Pigeon, I like Pigeon. Pigeon is a very lightweight chat client. Not that too many people use chat clients anymore. Thunderbird and Transmission. I don't use Thunderbird, but I do use Transmission. Office, it has LibreOffice, which is cool. What others? And then a dictionary. And then a document viewer. IceDove. That's cool. I haven't seen IceDove used in a while. Sound and video. Play movies. Sound juicer. Copy music from your CDs. Not a fan of Rhythmbox. Cheese is okay. Administration. This is basically your system tools, I think. Preferences. We got our display here. Let's see if we can change the. No. I'm beginning to think that's just the driver, but a lot of Linuxes were able to do it. And places. Alright, so I'm just really not a fan of a lot of it, but here's like a control thing. Startup applications, extensions, desktop. You can theme. Let's look at the backgrounds. That's my phone. Sorry, it's my alarm. Tell me to get to work. Yeah. It's all right. Would I use it? No, it's probably still a no. I like Debian-based systems, though, but I'm not a fan of this. I don't like it. Just clunky, I guess. I gotta figure out how to shut it off. What's this business? Oh, I can set the language. Right there. All right. Well, this is a look at Debian. All right. Have a good day. Well, as soon as it shuts down. And as always, thank you for watching.